The R&D tax incentive is massively important for R&D in Australia. It enables companies to take risks and perform experiments where the outcome of that work is uncertain.
Vaxxas are trying to transform delivery of vaccines by developing a needle-free vaccine technology. It's a small patch containing a dense array of little micro-projections, which are coated in vaccine. The product will improve vaccination access around the world.
HiQ is a business focused on the global textile industry. One of the key challenges that we see is how we can support this need of humanity for textiles, but to be able to build textiles cleaner with less impact on the environment.
Chobani is a relatively new company. We started 10 years ago in the US, but the Australian story started about 8 years ago, and we're on a mission to deliver better food for more people.
Raygen is an Australian business that's developed a unique technology that enables renewable energy to be dispatched on demand at very low cost. No one else in the world does what we have achieved.
It was an early idea that needed to be transformed into a commercial reality. And to do that requires a considerable research and development effort across all areas of the technology. So the R&D tax incentive has helped to build that data that we can take to partners to encourage further investment into our company and open up more chances for collaboration with large pharma companies, but also with universities and philanthropic organisations around the world.
When we first started manufacturing Chobani in Australia, we assumed that it would be very similar to the product from the USA because we were using the same cultures, we were using the same milk, but the profile of the milk here is quite different. So we actually had to do a lot of work up front to understand that, and the R&D tax incentive helped enable that.
So the R&D tax incentive is a key enabler for us to do research. The short polymer fibre technology was invented here at Deakin University. We've partnered to take that really from a lab level and an idea level to build that up in a way that can be scaled up and actually used in products around the world.
We've had to do a lot of innovation. That means a lot of cost involved to develop a new product and to actually prove that to a point where you know it's working. The really important thing about the R&D tax incentive is that it has helped provide a catalyst to get private equity in to support our R&D activities.
R&D promotes growth. We're now buying literally 80 million litres of milk, which is benefiting all of our local farmers, and pretty much the vast majority of our supply of all of our ingredients is now local. So that's a direct benefit to jobs in terms of food manufacturing, but also packaging producers.
A lot of our innovation activity is actually conducted here in Australia. The key reason for that is that we have this mechanism of collaboration with Deakin University, and this collaboration, supported by the R&D tax incentive, allows us to focus more problems that are relevant to the global textile market.
The R&D tax incentive is a catalyst for collaboration. It provides industry with a safety net to manage risk of investing in research, and it provides academics with an easier path to engage with industry and diversify our research and as well as our impact.
The R&D tax incentive has enabled us to do most of our research right here in Australia. So it's allowed us to hire those specialist people that has brought our product to a new level. Without those people, we wouldn't be able to do this.
There is a direct link between the R&D work that we do around our product qualities and our ability to attract great people to our business because they see what we're doing and they want to be part of it.
The R&D tax incentive has been absolutely fundamental to the success of our business. So without it, we certainly would not be here where we are today.
For more information about the Research and Development Tax Incentive, go to business.gov.au/RDTI.